Hello everyone, welcome to part 6 of my Cliffview project. Last time around, I relocated my industry across the river, and I caused myself some severe abandonment problems. It's not clear to me why this is a problem, but apparently it is. I suspect from some reading I've done that I've probably got too much commercial offices, and they're soaking up all of the workers. But if we take a look at the demographics, I've got 12% unemployment, so the workers should be coming over there. My theory then is that maybe I don't have enough places for these workers to live, or it's too far away. I certainly don't seem to have a traffic problem, and that's what has me baffled. So what I'm going to do is build a subdivision over here. A residential subdivision. But I'm going to take a different approach to this. I'm going to build a main road, and I'm going to do something I've read about. I'm going to put pedestrian pathways along the side of the road, and then I'm going to place the actual development off of the main road with some limited access. I think it'll look cooler that way. Now, I'm thinking I'm going to have a fairly large development in this area, so I'm going to actually set up for ultimately a 6-lane road, but I'm going to start out with 2 lanes each way. Okay, now, because the road is going to have to expand one grid, when it goes to 6 lanes, or even 3 lanes as a highway, I'm going to need to leave at least 2 here plus a gap, so I'm going to leave 3. And then here's the road going the other way. Okay. So I'm going to build yet another set of crazy ass ramps. So from here, I'm going to need a... Nope. Press the wrong mouse button there. I'm going to need to head off this way. Okay. And I'm going to need a ramp coming off, say, about here. Come on. Or apparently not. Maybe I can bring it off here. Or not. Okay. Ah, there we go. That'll work. Come on. It worked. I got it blue. There it is. Okay. Okay. And I'll take a bit off here. So these guys can get there. Okay, so far so good. Now I need to merge. Okay, that needs to go the other way. Good. Now, I also need a ramp coming around here. Okay. Right, I need that knot on upgrade. Okay, now can I bring it across from here? What's annoying is that it often takes the curve the wrong way around. Okay, here we go. Come on. Come on. Too steep? What does it mean, too steep? The hell? That made no sense. Okay. There we go. Okay, I need to rejigger this one. Okay. There we go. Now, my research says that the Sims will behave better on the highway if you mix both left and right entrances and exits. So, I'm going to work on that theory here. Okay, so with this setup, everybody can get from everywhere to everywhere else, and it looks like a mess. Sounds like a perfect setup for an interchange. Okay. Now, I can go over here and start making a mess. Now, I said I was going to put pedestrian pathways down the side here. Nope, I need to go out this far. And here. Yeah, I think that's kind of good. Now, I can ultimately bounce these over here, and I think I'll probably do that. Okay, but I'm gonna have to do that. There we go. Okay, that gets me an up. Okay. And that gets me an up there. I should be able to come across like that. And I should be able to get across all the way here. So I'm going to try that. If I turn that off, then I can get it to come over here. And if I turn that back on. That didn't line up right. Okay. Okay. Okay, so far so good. Now, theoretically, I should be able to link that up. There we go. Okay, so that'll give me pedestrian pathway across the highway. And I think that's a good thing. Now, I can also bring a path down to the bus station here. Okay. Now, I'm going to extend my one-way roads here straight some distance further. And now, I'm going to make a crossroad. Come on, straighten. There we go. Okay, so that's 1, 2, 3, 4, road. Yes, that's where I want it. And yes, I am going with yet another grid. If I could drive the mouse, I would be anyway. Okay. Uh, I need a one more road connection. Okay. Whoops, no. I need to bring my pathway all the way up here. There we go. Yes, that gives me a level crossing at the intersection, but I'm not overly worried about that. I could come along back here and build a bridge if I really thought it was worth it, which I don't at the moment. Okay, now I'm going to extend my grid here. Okay, so that's my setup there. Now, I clearly need to bring some services in here. So I'll do that first with water. Okay. Okay, so that gets me water in. And I'm clearly going to need some electricity to get across to there somehow. So I'll bring it across this way. Okay, so that should work. And I'm going to, before I start adding services or people in there, I'm going to add some park type affairs. Because they can't harm anything. And I'm going to add a health facility, which will live, well, let's make it live right about here. And I'm going to build one of these nice places right about here. Now we need a fire station, which can live right about here. And a police station, which can live right about here. I'm also going to want a elementary school, which I'll stick here, and a high school, which I'll place here. This is just random. So, you know, that's fine. Now, I'm down to zoning. Now, I'm going to zone this one as low density. So, here we go. Start out here. I may need to speed the simulation up so that things actually do something. So I'll do that. Come on. Oh, right. One more thing I'm going to do is add a road connection in here. Okay, so that's developing now. So I'll extend that a bit. And it's developing some more, so I can run this across. By doing it that way, I force it to develop toward the electricity supply rather than away from it. Now that I've got electricity in there, that's not so much of a problem. I'll zone the rest of these blocks in. So I'm going to work on the theory that I didn't have enough residential, enough places for people to actually live. That's one thing that the demographics don't actually tell you is your homeless level. And I think that would be an important statistic if it was available, assuming there is a homeless level. And hey, look at that. That's actually quite a bit fewer. No worker zots there. Well, who knew? And look at that, I have people coming over the pedestrian bridges. That's really cool. Okay, so I'm not going to zone right up against the main road here. What I am going to do is extend my pathway here. Okay. And this one too. It turns out people actually use these things, so that's really kind of cool. So if I bring a few linkages through, I might actually get even more usage. So if I bring one across at every street here, there's no reason why not. I don't have that limited space here, so why not? Now, if I move that garden here, say over here, I can actually put a pedestrian bridge. I'll have to move this over one as well. Like so. I can do. Where is that bridge there, or the path thing. So okay, so that gives me a pedestrian bridge. Will that actually take the pedestrians over? Yes, it does. I like that. Nice. I kind of like that aesthetically, too. And no zots. Nice. Maybe my commute times were too long. Anyway, let's add some more here and see what happens. Because it used to have a lot more, so let's see what happens here. Okay, let's take a look at the worker setup here. I've got none, I got one. Two. Three, four. Come on, get some workers. So it needs 16 workers here. Okay. Yeah, there's my Zot. Oh, it got to 16. So I've determined that if it has half the total workers, it decides it's got enough workers, even though it can support twice as many. And there's... it's over half. Okay, excellent. I like... okay. Okay, so what I'll come along and do now is bounce this development across the main road I'm setting up here. Okay, so I'll turn this around. Yeah, I have another bridge I need to build the road first. Okay, I will do that. Okay. Oops, this is what I need. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. Is that right? It is. Good. Okay. Now I can build my pathways here. I'm going to slow this back down. Pave pathway. Bring it all the way up to the road. Okay. Now I need my... 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's 5 back. Okay, good. I've got my bridge there. Now, I need my grid over on this side. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 2. Okay. Now. So that's 3 rows. Four. four rows. Okay, so the distortion here is due to the slope of the ground. You can see that if I do this. It's not that the grid is off. Okay, and I'll go one more. Okay. Okay, that's the grid. Now, I still need my services here. So, here we go. Oh, I need, I'll go bird's eye here. Okay. And here. And here. Now, I need a few services here. Start with a elementary school, which will go over here. High school, which will go over here. Healthcare, I'll set one up over... Well, set it up over here. One of these fancy crematorium places I'll stick over here. No, I'll stick it over here. Police and fire can be over here. And good old Japanese garden parks. Like so. Now, I can go ahead and... Well, first off, I'm going to put some commercial right along here. Oh, I need to finish those paths there. Okay. Pathways. Okay, this is easy enough. Okay. Now, I'll set up commercial along here as well. Oh yes, I forgot. For completeness, I'm going to bring paths up like so. Okay. Now let's see. Do I need... I don't need to do anything for power. Excellent. Okay. Now, the purpose here is residential zoning, so I better do some of that. I'll zone this all in. Excellent. Now, I'm going to speed the game up again, and we'll see how this goes. I read somewhere that even when there's low residential demand on the RCI graphs, that sometimes you still need to build residential. That might be down to different classes that it doesn't actually advertise. Anyway, While I'm fiddling around here, I'm going to bring a road out across the highway here. Like so. That should give a little better access into the area and across to the industrial. Should bypass a little bit of traffic up on here, as I noticed that it was setting up with a fair bit. And I suspect I'd have a hard time actually upgrading this. So here we go. Oh, whoops. So I'm going to take a look at my demographics again. Okay. So I'm inverted here. I have seniors dying off in droves, of course. But my unemployment rate is now way down. That's paradoxical, because I have higher population and I haven't really increased the number of jobs available. Not appreciably. So let's take a look at this guy. Now, he's good. What about this guy? Yeah, he's not. Now, of course, I'm attracting primarily families here, so a lot of the population growth is going to be children. And that's definitely going to make things take a little while to even out. Okay, yeah, that went too long. Okay. Okay, what's my demographics? Whoops. 7% children, 15%. Okay, yeah, so I've got 22% that aren't going to be working, so yeah. Okay, so good. Well, while I'm at this, I'm going to expand this area. Okay, so I had one, two, I had three there. So, whoops. I'm going to build the grid. I should actually set it on the right settings for that. Okay. Okay, there's... That's the second. That's the third. And that's where the connector will be. You're wondering why I did that with the roads. It allowed me to get my angles correct. Now, come on. Really, I can't do that? Okay, so I'll try something else here. Why did that? Okay. Really? There we go. That's a little bit iffy, but it'll do. No. I need to extend... No, I need to put it back on here. I need to extend that a little bit. Build my intersection. Now, I'm going to bring my pathway along. I'm going to bring it along over here, too. Good. Now, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm going to build a bridge here. Okay, so I have a bridge there. It occurs to me that I might want a linkage here. Maybe one here. Maybe one here. Actually, there, I think. Okay. Now, actually, I'm going to slow this down. Back to the regular roads. Two, three, and up, and okay, that's linkages there. Good. Now, as you can see, this gets a little bit tedious when you're just following a pattern repeatedly. But I kind of like this pattern, at least for this area. So, pattern it is. How's elementary school? Okay, I'll stash one over here. High school should be good, and so should the police coverage, so it's just down to water pipes. Now, yeah, I didn't follow it around on the road there. I'm gonna let my I'm gonna tell my CDO to take a hike this time. In case you haven't heard of CDO before, you know, if you missed it the last time I talked about it, that's OCD, but in alphabetical order. Okay, so now some more residential. I could put high density in, but I have this feeling I have enough high density over on the other side of the river for now. So I'm gonna set up my urban sprawl. Okay, I'll speed this up now, let that fill in. And I'll put on my demographics. I got a 9% unemployment rate now. Okay, so based on that, I'll give another block over here. Okay, so hopefully this soaks up some of the jobs I have available, and also starts to actually supply. Oh, hey, the bus is connecting with the pathway. Nice. That's brilliant. Look at all those busy pedestrians. Okay, now that I've done that, I'm going to take a look in here. Unemployment's still 10%. Okay, I've got my zots here. So, are they going to manage to find workers? One did. Well, there's eight now. Come on, find a worker. There we go. Zot goes away. Nice, nice, nice. And it's fixing to upgrade. Oh, it almost had it. Sewage is backing up. Okay, let's take a look. What? What happened? Pause. Where's my sewage outlets here? No power. Oh. Power. Duh, that would do it. Well, I'm gonna stick a solar power plant in over here. Right, a space already occupied. Okay, well, I'll stick it right. No. What if I stick it here? Yeah, that'll work. And we start things rolling again. That's enough power. And there we go, I have enough sewage. Well, that should sort out all of that stuff. Not enough workers there, huh? Oh wow, the sewage thing solved, and wham, a bunch of people coming. Okay, is it gonna get enough workers in time? It needs one more. There we go. And now it's upgrading. And now it won't have enough. Just needs two more. Come on. Ooh. Big jump. And it's really nice to see this, you know, the massive pedestrians going on here. I'm gonna pause this and follow this guy. These pedestrians will go a long way. And they will climb steep-ass pathways. Oh, onto the bridge. He's an educated senior. And he's going home. This is kind of cool, being able to follow random citizens. And he's at home. Who's this guy? He's an educated adult. Let's follow him. And now he's at home. Now he's going to work. Let's see. Whee! Blast across the walkway. And we down to the bus stop. And he waits for a month at the bus stop. Now he's unemployed. Oh, he's a senior now. Teleported. It occurs to me that I have enough traffic waiting for the bus there that maybe I would benefit from a metro line wrapping around to there. Oops. We go. Okay, now I will also bring a pathway down to there. Okay, now let's see. Does that lighten the load on the bus stop? I think it does. Yes. The bus stop is clearing. The metro stop, of course, is collecting traffic. Okay. Well, who's this guy? Let's follow that guy. He's going home. Ooh, he's over on this side. Wild. Okay, he's at home. He works at the high school, even. Wild. He's going to organic food market. La-di-da-di-dum. Whee! Whee! And we go into the okay, here we can see the frame rate issues. Oh my. Yeah, that bus stop's overloaded. I might want to consider increasing my transit budget. Okay. Budget. transit. Right, it's over here. Metro buses. Let's bump that and see what happens. Okay. Okay, interesting. Okay, so the metro line's working. Where are the stops? One there. Okay. I think it was this stop here. I might consider a transit capacity mod here, as I think 30 is a bit low for bus capacities. But I do have something of an insane level of long routes here, so I may need to consider some other options too, like maybe some metro connections. But this seems to be working nicely. Since I'm not zoning along here, I'm actually going to, just before I end this part here, I'm going to turn these side roads into, highways. That'll move the traffic along these a little faster. I could have got away with one less square in between, but if For the most part, it works fairly well. I think it looks okay. This is a major road, so with limited access, so it seems like it works okay this way. But my plan here is that this is going to be a major thoroughfare, probably into here. So I'm probably going to bend it around here and go off this way. Oh, look, we have some mesas over here. So having higher capacity here is probably a good idea. I think most of this area here is going to be residential. I'm not sure. I haven't decided yet exactly how I'm going to plan it out. But I'm going to take a quick look at the demographics here. Now, this is demographics. Unemployment's 14%. So I'm going to come along over here and fill in these wrong. These two with zoning. And yeah, I think that will be it for this part. Yeah, okay, this is good. I may extend the zoning here a bit into this area with the industrial. Might put a crossroads over here. Remember, these are highway ramps. Okay, yes. So I'm going to call that the end of the part. Let's see if I end up with a crashed save game this time. Save. Apparently not. I'm paranoid. Okay, that says now, so good. So now I'm going to call that the end of part six. And I'll see everybody back for part seven, which is probably going to be more residential expansion in the new area. Oh, that was interesting. I just crashed. Oh, well, that's the end of this part, and thank you for watching.